Hello, I am Zinfogel. In this video, I will run you through Regirock's legendary arena and help you assess your best options to defeat him. Let's get started. With the exception of Hyper Beam, all of Regirock's attacks are physical. Regirock starts the battle weak to grass, but when he reaches his second health bar, he becomes weak to steel for the remainder of the fight. Regirock has a passive called Shrug Off that renders him immune to any stat drop. A side effect of this passive is that critical hits lower Regirock and your party's defense. As a result, crits are the only way to debuff Regirock. Regirock loves critting himself. Critical hits bypass defensive buffs, which makes Vigilance borderline mandatory for this fight. Regirock will also passively raise his attack, defense, accuracy, and critical hit rate as the battle progresses. Regirock is highly resistant to every status condition and interference. During his first health bar, he's an outright immune to anything, but this changes on his second health bar, where Regirock gains Sin Cure, Listen Affliction, and Listen Interference. At this stage, any status is only effective once before Regirock becomes immune to it. During the first health bar, Regirock doesn't do anything too special, other than setting up Iron Defense when he reaches 50% HP. Iron Defense raises defense by a couple of stages, and also sets up a critical shield which brings your offense to a stall. The second health bar is where Regirock becomes really dangerous. He will open this phase with a sure crit Rock Slide, and follow it up with Iron Defense. Regirock also becomes capable of dropping a special attack with Satisfy the Snarl 9. On this phase, Regirock gains several entry passives, such as Terrify 4, Demoralize 4, and Safeguard Entry, which will activate whenever Regirock sinks or you enter the battle with a new team. At the third health bar, Regirock opens with another sure crit Rock Slide. He stops using Iron Defense and instead opts for strong single target attacks. This is a part where I normally tell you which methods are viable to defeat Regirock, but I am not going to sugarcoat things. You have to have specific resources if you want that 4-star medal. On previous legendary arenas, you could get by with minimally gridded free-to-play units and smart play, but the fact that Regirock crits constantly, cannot be debuffed, and cannot be cheesed with the status severely limits our options. At a minimum, you require highly invested free-to-play units or several tanks with Vigilance as a lucky skill. The method I will show today requires a max Solgaleo, 3-5 Skyla, and Phoebe as the most steep investments, and even then it's highly RNG reliant. However, I will run you through a checklist of sync pairs who make a Regirock a lot easier. Rosa, Skyla, and Barry is the archetypal free-to-play team and one of the strongest cores in the game. Barry is a strong self-sufficient striker with massive sync nukes, and Rosa sustains herself with Giga Rain. Skyla is weak to rock, but she can protect the party with defense buffs and potions, while Rosa takes care of tanking. This is a viable structure for most legendary arenas, but Barry has to have a 3-5 grid. Rosa wants to be raised to 6-star EX potential, and both Rosa and Skyla need Vigilance as lucky skills in order to survive. Jasmine is a strong physical tank with a key advantage. Her trainer move provides immunity to critical hits and debuffs for a short period of time. With good timing, Jasmine can protect your party from Regirock's crit Rock Slides. If Jasmine is at 3-5 potential, she can regain health constantly with Recuperation too, and actually performs as a powerful striker with super effective Iron Tails. Signasu Blue is incredibly tanky, and depending on his sync level, might even protect your party for the entire encounter. Safety Net is a huge advantage for Signasu Blue because it will protect your party from Regirock's Rock Slide crits if you cannot circumvent them otherwise. The problem is that Blastoise absolutely needs Vigilance as a lucky skill to be able to survive. Dawn is a massive tank with AoE defense buffs and innate Vigilance. She tanks well, but I find that she needs to be partnered with healers like Sinasu Leaf or Vigilance Skyla to be able to outlast Regirock. Solgaleo is a limited free-to-play legendary sync pair, and works very well against Regirock. Sunsteel Strike is a physical move that takes advantage of Shrug Off defense drops. Solgaleo also has Impervious as a passive to block Terrify 4. I think it goes without saying that Steven is a powerful striker, but that is especially true for Regirock because of super effective damage, recuperation too, and Impervious as passives. Iron Head is also a key tool to flinch down Regirock and prevent damage on his fierce hellbar. Gloria can do a number to Regirock, but her lack of defensive utility means that she needs powerful defensive partners to survive the encounter. She works really well for Regirock's steel hellbar to deal massive damage with Behemoth Blade. There are several viable means of dealing with Regirock, but if you have any of these particular sim pairs, they will make the encounter a lot simpler. Iron Defense and Shurikree Rock Slide are the most debilitating moves Regirock performs. The former prevents you from progressing faster through the fight, while the latter greatly weakens your strikers and can even knock them out. Iron Defense and Rock Slide are scripted to happen at specific points throughout the fight. If you disable Regirock with Flinch, Sleep, or Freeze, right when he's about to execute these actions, Regirock will outright skip them and continue his normal script. Knowing this, flinching strikers like Steven or Brendan have an edge to greatly improve your chances of success. One last thing I like to mention is the build-up method. Given the fact that Regirock isn't immune to sleep on his fierce hellbar, you can perform a sleep chain to stall Regirock and build up sync buffs. To perform this method, you require 3-5 Skyla for Ghost MGR9 and preferably Serena to sleep chain consistently. Essentially, only the both of them perform a sleep chain to minimize damage. Once you stack a lot of sync buffs, you can let your striker loose and quickly defeat the Regirock's second and third hellbars. I won't cover this method today, but I will link some resources down in the description from other members of the community who made examples on how to perform this. Alright, let's get this down. Just as a fair warning, Regirock is by far the hardest legendary arena to date, so don't be disappointed if you perform poorly. You will probably need several attempts and resets to get through the hellbars efficiently, but it's because Regirock is really, really tough. The methodology I am using today was developed by Hugo, so credits to them, I will link their Reddit thread in the description, but essentially we're going to be using a grass-type striker to take out the fierce hellbar, and then bring a very strong Solgaleo core to take out the second hellbar and a majority of the tier hellbar, and then use another team to clean up what remains. For my approach, I scrapped together some free-to-play resources to take care of the fierce hellbar. Is this the best way to do this? Absolutely not. You could be replacing Brock with a more reliable tank like Dawn, you could replace Erika with Brendan or Gardenia, you could replace Torchic with Sabrina or Signature Lessa. It all depends on your available resources, so if you have better units, you should be using them instead. However, this is still a free-to-play method, so everybody has access to these units. Brock here is packing a 1-5 grid with Potion MPR. He's a decent physical tank and will survive Regirock's Onslaught to allow Erika to survive a little bit longer. Erika has a 1-5 DPS grid, including all the energy ball tiles as well as Paralysis Synergy 5. If you have a Silver and Ho-Oh, you could go for Healing Zone 2 on Erika's grid and tank with her instead. She could actually survive a Regirock semi-comfortably with some recovery. Torchic is just here to offer AoE offensive support, so Erika can actually deal some decent damage, and AoE crit buffs are very important for a fierce team because you also want to start working on Shrugoth debuffs. Remember that Shrugoth prevents any stat drop from happening except for defense drops derived from critical hits. Whenever you crit Regirock, it will debuff his defense by one stage. So because we're using a physical striker for the next hellbars, it is important that we at a minimum debuff Regirock below having defense buffs just to make it easier for a second team. But aside from that, this team is just spamming attacks, working those drops, trying to advance the sync countdown, and Brock is using potion when necessary to keep tanking Regirock. If you get really lucky, you could also potion Erika so she can survive a bit more reliably, because my Erika is actually quite chunky. She's a 5-star Erika with Vigilance, so this may or may not be the most fair comparison or option available for free-to-play players, but She can still do decent damage, especially if you raise her to her 2-5 grid. She could be using Confusion Synergy with Flabbergast. There are several different ways you could be approaching this, but this is just what I tossed together, and it's not necessarily the best approach available either way. But this is the point where your team might get overwhelmed, especially because Regirock sets up Iron Defense when he reaches 50% HP, and it gets a lot harder to get through the health bar. But if you can get to that final sync buff with Erika, she should be able to melt what remains of Regirock's health bar and allow you to advance to the next phase, which is extremely important because here what we need Erika to do is tank the Shurkrit Rock Slide so that the next team doesn't have to deal with that. It is extremely important that you survive to this point. And now for the main show. Here we have a basic Solgaleo team composition. Solgaleo is a decent striker, but it requires a crit and a speed support to function properly, and Phoebe and Skyla provide that respectively. Even though Skyla is weak to rock, she is a fantastic support for this encounter because she provides AoE defense buffs as well as consistent potions, and as you will see, Skyla will be on full potion overdrive so we can make it through this encounter, but we will manage. I am choosing Phoebe because she has a crucial perk that other crit supports lack, and that is innate vigilance. You don't have to reroll the Loki skill for her to have a crit immunity, and you have to have vigilance to tank Regirock. That is not optional. So for that reason, I believe Phoebe is the most accessible crit tank you could be using for this encounter. Outside of that, Skyla has a 3-5 grid with potion MPR tiles, so just enhance her chances of proccing it, and Solgaleo is 5-5 20-20, the little boy is maxed out, and now everybody can have this potential because DNA is handing out the full resources to fully max out legendary simpers, so that is very nice. But this plays out as a standard encounter, but you just have to watch out for Regirock's damage. Do not underestimate Regirock's damage potential. Even at maximum defense with a Take Flight NPR, Phoebe will still get vented really hard because her defenses are mediocre for today's tanking standards. So every time Regirock executes a Stone Edge or Drain Punch, you basically have to preemptively answer with a potion so she can make it through the next attack. And it's a little tricky to manage the timing once you started learning the encounter and also managing the potion NPR procs, but either way. Notice here that Regirock used Demoralize 4 and Terrify 4 again. This happens every time Regirock sinks. So this is where Solgaleo is crucial as a striker, because he has Impervious as an innate passive, so he's completely immune to any stat drops, and can ignore those re-entry passives that Regirock packs, which is where Gloria, for example, would pale as a striker in this phase, because she just gets crippled so hard by the attack drops that she cannot perform as efficiently as a striker who has their attack maxed out, like Steven or Solgaleo crit. So there isn't a whole lot to see here, I'm just spamming potions and letting Solgaleo take care of everything, but when we reach this point, when Regirock uses his second sync, I let Phoebe go because she has outlived her usefulness, and I kinda had to dedicate resources for Skyla and Solgaleo to keep surviving the battle because they are far more important. Specifically, you need Solgaleo to be able to do enough damage so that you take down a vast majority of the tier health bar. At the very least, if you want a 4-star medal, it will be very difficult to do so with fresh teams because Regirock hits incredibly hard, and you need Solgaleo to take care of most of these health bars so that the last couple teams can finish off Regirock, and the more damage you can get going, the better. At a minimum, you want to reach 50% HP on this health bar. If you can do more than that, better. If you can kill Regirock, even better. But you just have to do as much damage as possible, and the luckier you get with potion NPR, the better. If Skyla has vigilance as a passive here, she will also deal with this a lot more easily, but you may or may not have access to that lucky skill. And now for the cleanup crew, I am choosing Molayne because he's free to play and has super effective damage against Regirock, physical super effective damage, that is preferable. And much like Solgaleo, Molayne needs crit support, so Maylene is here to provide for that. and X-Slash is tanking. Wikstrom could actually do as a striker on this phase, but I like X-Slash for tanking because he has Vigilance as an innate passive and can also block a couple attacks with King Shield. So if you scout the battle ahead of time and learn Regirock's script, it's not going to change when you reset. You could time King Shield so that you block Hammer Arm or Stone Edge or the more dangerous attacks on this phase and allow X-Slash to soak up some damage so that Maylene and Molayne don't have to deal with that. Now the problem here is that it is very likely that Molayne will fail to kill Regirock before a sink happens. In that case, he will have to tank the sink, which he can do fine at base if you give him some gears, but he will have to survive a non-crit sink. If he gets crit, he will die. So if that happens, you will have to bring another team or just figure out another solution. But here I have to reset to prevent Molayne dying from the crit sink. But once we go through that, then Maylene can survive another hit, and then Molayne should have enough power to take out Regirock. Yeah? So there you have it. Regirock, a nightmare of a legendary arena. Honestly, I cannot blame you if you cannot execute this. This is honestly really difficult. Like, I had a lot of difficulties figuring out the free-to-play strat myself, which I haven't had issues with on previous legendary arenas. But if you put enough effort and you scrutinize your resources very carefully, then you might be able to scrap something here. So, best of luck to you. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.